In preseason of the 2019 season, we set a goal to be OIC champs.
This was especially a big goal for us, considering we hadn't won the championship since 1999.
I knew with the past season's success and all the potential we had, that it was a goal that we were able to reach.
When they told me that their goal was to win an OAC championship, I was taken back a little bit just because we had never gotten that far, but I knew that we could get there and get them to their goal.
We went into preseason, which was very intense. We typically had practice 3 times a day, a lot of working out. We had fitness tests, but somehow we made some really hard work fun.
We always had a tendency to make everything fun. It didn't matter if it was in the weight room, after a long practice, sitting in the ice tank, trying to keep our breaths. We were still laughing and having fun, no matter what we were doing.
We started off on a 10-0 streak, and then we found out that we were facing 13-ranked Hope.
I remember the gym was like 100 degrees. We had to play in our short sleeve jerseys that we hated playing in because it was so hot. We had no other choice.
Before we played Hope, we went back into the locker room, which there were so many teams there, we had to share a locker room. And we played Footloose, and we all at that point knew how to do the Footloose dance. So we're just breaking out into Footloose with everyone staring at us thinking we're crazy right before we go out and play the 13th ranked team in the country.
I think we just talked about nothing to lose against a ranked team just because we were an unranked team, and just to go out and have fun and just play the best that they could.
We went into gameplay and Brooke stuffed their right side and the bench went nuts, and we were like, holy crap, like we just got the first point against Hope. And then we just kept getting more points.
I just remember we were digging balls and I was like, we just got that up. And just having so much fun with it and not thinking about our strategy, just going out and playing volleyball and having fun with each other. I think they were getting really frustrated with us because we were just getting so hyped about everything. Like in ace, we were shoving each other, bench was going crazy.
Even after we had won that first set, I still didn't believe like we were gonna beat Hope. Like I still was like, we're the underdogs, like we're probably not gonna win.
Like we caught them off guard the first set.
And then we beat them in 3 sets.
I was kind of in shock. I didn't realize that it had gone all 3 sets and that we had beat them in straight sets. I was just super proud of the way that our team had played.
After the success that we had that weekend, I remember coming to practice and our coach telling us that we are now ranked 25th in the nation, as it showed the potential that we could possibly have.
After finally being ranked, I felt this sense of like accomplishment, but I also knew that that's not what our end goal was. And so how do we push past that accomplishment?
Yeah, I definitely think having that confidence going into OAC play was huge, but also not in a cocky way, more of a, we know what we're capable of, and just walking into a gym and being like, it doesn't matter who's on the other side of the net, we're going to play our game and we're going to have fun and we're going to beat you. So
we started off conference play playing a 15th ranked Ohio Northern.
They were the only other nationally ranked team in the OAC other than us. And so it was definitely going to be our toughest matchup of the conference season.
Muskingum had not beaten Ohio Northern in volleyball for quite some time. So our upperclassmen definitely had some unresolved emotions towards ONU. And we really, really wanted to beat them. It's really hard to think of them as just another team with the history of competition we have with them.
I just wanted to win so bad, and I mean, it went to 5 sets and we played good volleyball and they were just able to take that one.
We all felt very defeated right after the game because we were very excited to hopefully start off on a winning streak. But after the game, I think it lit a fire under us.
And after that, it just felt like everything was trying to click.
After our loss to 15th-ranked Ohio Northern, we went on a long winning streak, ended up beating every other team in the conference.
I think when you look at each game as your next goal and do small goals rather than one big goal, it kept us looking just for the next thing and not too far in the future.
We just kind of took care of business with every single team. And I think a lot of that had to do with our team chemistry. I mean, we were just so close and we're always having fun.
We just wanted to see each other do so well, and having the depth that we did definitely allowed us to mix up some lineups if someone was having an off day or things just weren't going their way, just to get a different look. And our bench was the loudest no matter who was on the court and who was off. I got to experience the bench and be on the floor, and the bench was just as fun as being on the floor because every little thing that happened, we were going crazy. People falling down, stomping, smacking the ground until your hands were literally purple. Our last game of conference play was at Heidelberg, and before this game, we kind of realized, oh, if we win this game, like, we're guaranteed OIC champs. So there was some pressure with that, knowing that.
I didn't want to tell the team what all rode against the Heidelberg game, just because I didn't want to add any extra pressure. Coaching staff had a lot of pressure on them to win that game. And I don't know if the team was more on it than I thought, because I felt like point one, there was a lot of pressure on them.
You're playing at Heidelberg, and they had a very big fan base, which made us a little nervous. And I think that the nerves threw us off a little bit and played a part in us losing the first set. And we then went into the second set, just working as hard as we could. Also came short on that one.
Here we are in our third set. If we lose this, the game is over. Like, I just feel like we had no question that we were going to beat Heidelberg, and not in a cocky way. We just like knew that we could do it, but everything was so hard. We made every ball so difficult, and it just didn't feel like our team whatsoever.
It didn't feel like us.
And then somehow something clicked in that third set. I think it was, if we don't go now, like, this is our last chance. And we just didn't want to go out like that. And I don't feel like it was our best playing still, but we did enough. We knew that we were off, and we were like, everyone has off days and we just need to figure it out. And somehow we figured it out, and we took those next two sets and brought it to a fifth set somehow.
Finally, we got something that was starting to work. Like, okay, this kind of feels like us. We fight back to get in this fifth set, and it is a straight up battle, point by point.
We really kind of let off the gas at the end, and you know, fifth set only goes to 15 points. They were at 14 in their game point, and we only had 11. And at that point, you know, you kind of start to think the game's over. They only need one more point.
We didn't know how we were going to do it, but we were like, we're not losing this game. And before we know it, it's 13-14, and then we tie it up.
The game point is just a point that will always stick with me. We have watched it on film so many times. But our right side, Kate, hit down the line. That game point is just like, it's stuck in all of our heads forever. It's stuck in our coach's head forever. I think she went more crazy than anyone else did after that.
Doing tuck jumps after on game point. We were all hugging each other. There were tears.
We were all so excited that our goal had finally come true and all our hard work had finally paid off.
As soon as that last point hit, I was like, holy crap, like, this team did it. And they did something that nobody else thought that they could do. They all had the same goal. A lot of teams, you know, the individuals have their goals, but every single player on that team had the same goal.
So after winning at Heidelberg, we were just on a high. and getting rings never really was a thought in our mind. But then we had to give our ring sizes to the captains because they got to design them. The detail, we were just kind of like mesmerized by it. I'm so obsessed with it. And on the inside it says Muskingum, and to me that's probably my favorite part because that would be like our huddle break throughout the season. I don't know why, we just made it up really early in the season, like Muskingum. But that just exemplifies like the goofiness of our team, which I think was like the major aspect of our team that allowed us to be so successful. And that is what I remember most about the team in 2019.
I don't think like rankings and like national stuff really, it mattered to us, but like that wasn't really on the forefront of our minds because we were taking it game by game. We were focused on our conference at the time, and it was like out of nowhere we went from never being ranked to finally hitting the rankings once season started. And then by the time that we started worrying about the tournament, we were ranked 11th in the country.
Not only did we make it to the NCAA tournament, but we won the first round.
Yeah, I don't think anybody looking at us from August 16th on thought that we would make it to the NCAA tournament. And I think that having that kind of an underdog feeling really drove that team to prove everybody wrong.
The 2019 Muskingum women's volleyball team was full of heart.
Was passionate.
And moxie.
Was unforgettable.